And good evening, everyone. This is the RCG Global TV Network, aka the People's Network. And in a few minutes, you are truly going to understand why they call us the People's Network. I'm so just blessed to have this gentleman with me tonight to discuss an up and coming show that he's going to have live on Facebook. Now, this man, he's an incredible gift from God. We all are, but he's a phenomenal gifted gift of God. And his gift is delivering. And if you don't know what I'm talking about, he's going to explain exactly what I mean by deliverance. But I want to introduce you to a man that I know is PK, and you can tell you his government name if you want to. You know how we do. We don't disclose that type of information on everybody. But I know him as PK. Many people, thousands of people know him as PK, the prophet. And I want you to get to know him and just, again, get ready for what we're going to do Facebook Live on October 24th at 7 p.m. Eastern. So without any further ado, let me introduce Prophet, my brother, PK. How are you, sir?
I'm very good. I'm blessed, sir. It's a pleasure to meet you, you know, be here, Troy. You know, it was awesome. It was God in meeting you. You know, that was really something else. And I thank you for the opportunity and what you're doing to bring God to the people right now. May God bless you for, amen, the works that you're doing for the kingdom, sir.
Well, thank you. Thank you. And, you know, I'm just another vessel that has embraced my role. And I'm obligated. My duty in being obedient is bringing you to the people. Right. We know there's a lot of pain and a lot of suffering going on out there. And, you know, not everybody is in the kingdom in the way of the word, that they do have dominion and authority over everything in their life, including pain and suffering. So we got to help them. We got to help them understand the power that God has created in them. And you're going to help really a lot of people understand that by demonstrating the power, not only of prayer, but the power of belief in the words that are spoken into them. So tell the people, PK, exactly what prophesizing and deliverance actually means.
Okay. You know, to understand what deliverance means, you got to understand who you are. And when I say who you are, not the flesh, but the spirit. You know, in Genesis 1, you know, God says, let us create man. And the word says he created he, him, and she, her. If you read on, it says he did not let it rain on earth because there was no one to till the ground. So if there was no one on earth to take care of the earth, where were we when he created us? Right? All right, so the word says that God is a spirit, okay, and they that worship him shall worship him in spirit and in truth. You know, so if we weren't on earth, where were we? Well, we were in heaven, because we always hear God made us in his image, and God is not flesh. So a lot of times we look in the mirror and we say, hey, wow, you know, God is good looking, you know, or, man, look at me, I look like God. But we're looking at the wrong thing. God created us and we're spirit. So here's the thing. He later on in the word said, let us form man, right? Let's make man. And he took the clay and he made Adam, right? He blew the breath of life into him. And then he put him to sleep. He took the rib and it says he made Eve and blew the breath of life into her. Well, guess what? The breath of life that he put was the male spirit into Adam and the female spirit into Eve. Why did he create these bodies to live on earth, right? And not just bring us down here the way we were in the spirit form. Okay. Real simple. our bodies cannot live, and where we live on earth, it's in a realm of time. It's in a realm of time. So our bodies cannot live in time comfortably. Okay, so he created these bodies to house our spirits. Now watch this. In space, if you ever check out when man is going up, you know, NASA is sending people into space, they're training underwater. Why is he training them underwater? Because in space, that's the effect you're going to have. You're going to have that weightlessness, and that's where the spirit lives comfortably. If you check the scriptures, it says when the unclean spirit goes walking, it leaves the home, it goes walking in dry places. Well, it's uncomfortable. It turns around. The scripture says it goes back to the home. It finds the home clean, garnished, and swept, and brings seven demons more worse than itself, and the state of the man is worse than it is before. So why does it want to be in the home? The home is the body. Why does it want to be in there? Because of how God made it. It's amazing. But your body is made of 80% water. Is that coincidental? Or is that to give you the effect of being in heaven? Okay, where your spirit is comfortable. So that is why we have these bodies. So now what happens is, and this is where deliverance comes in, demons, like where it was talking in the scripture, where the unclean spirit goes, you know, walking, it leaves the home and goes walking in dry places, it comes back. Well, the demon being in that home, it's in the body. It's in your body. So when anything attaches itself to your body, you want to get it out. The only spirit that should be in there is the spirit that God gave you, and the Holy Spirit in the story. So what happens is we have deliverance. The reason, and here's the thing, you know, a lot of you have sicknesses and you say, well, you know, the doctor said, okay, well, here's this. What happens is Ephesians 6 and 12, all right, in the scripture, if you get your Bible, you can read this. It says, we wrestle not against flesh and blood. So the things that we're struggling with, it's not flesh and blood. But it's principalities, it's powers, it's rulers of darkness, and spiritual wickedness in high places, all right? So these are the things that's attacking our bodies, okay? So now, amen, in Mark 16 and 17, it says, and these signs shall follow them that believe. In my name, you should cast out devils or demons and speak in new tongues, all right? So we have the power and the authority to cast these things out. But like the scripture said, it'll follow these people who believe. Okay, do I believe? Absolutely, I've seen it. You know, from way back in the days when I was a kid with R.W. Schombach up in the Bronx and so on. You know, so I've learned and through the power and the instruction of the Holy Spirit on what I have to say and what has to be done to remove these things so people can be healed. And a lot of times the healing is instantaneously. Here's what though. It depends on one thing. There's something that can hold it back, okay? Unforgiveness. If there's anybody in your life that has done you wrong or has hurt you, I don't care what level of pain or hurt you have, you got to forgive them. You know, Jesus said in the prayer, forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those that trespass against us. So we're not going to be forgiven unless we forgive. So these are the ingredients to a great deliverance. Okay, and with that, I yield the mic. Amen. God bless y'all.
Wow, bro. You went deep right there with that explanation, but much needed. Much needed. I've learned a few things, especially the power of forgiveness, holding back. Well, we always say, you can't hold on to things because it's blocking your blessings. That's the way a lot of people understand that, but you just put it a different way. With the forgiveness factor and being able to be delivered. And I'm quite sure that people suffering deep pains, they would deliver the worst, they would forgive the worst enemy to get rid of that pain. So not a lot to ask, not a big ask at all. So let's hear a couple of ways you have delivered people. A couple of instances.
Okay. Okay. A matter of fact, every day people call me for deliverance. I just had two people today. One lady, I have a spiritual daughter. She prays for people that get healed as well. you know, and I met her in 2012. She called me today and she said, listen, I'm praying for this lady for healing. And, you know, it's something, you know, I said, let me bring her to you. So I said, what's wrong? She told me her knee is bad and she had fell. So I'm thinking she fell this week, today, something, you know. So I'm like, okay. I said, let me pray, you know, and I prayed for her knee and I spoke to the situation and she said, you know, a lot of the pain has left. I said, well, when did you fall? She said, when I was 21. That was over 20 years ago. Okay, she's been dealing with this. And she actually got up and started praising God and walking around the house and said, oh my God, I can't believe this, you know. So amen. So God healed her. You know, and I thank God for that. Another lady contacted me. Wow, there's so many. You know, yeah, another lady contacted me the other day, and, you know, she was having an issue. I forgot her. It was really amazing. God, I'm sorry, I forget. When you're doing things in the spirit, know, it's not you, and sometimes it slips your mind. But, you know, I'm okay. A lady called me up the other day. Could I pray for her mom? Her mom is on the way to the hospital. She's having chest pain. She's blind in one eye. Also, the other eye, they did an operation on her, and it messed up her vision. I said, okay. She was on the way to the hospital, right? Her brother was taking her to the hospital. So we prayed, left it alone. By the time the next day came, I received a text message. I could send that to you. And I received a text message for the young lady. And she said, thank you so much for praying for my mother. When she got to the hospital, they ran tests. They couldn't find anything. And the doctor told her that all she has to do is check the other eye, have a doctor look at the other eye, and they should be able to get her vision back. But one eye was okay, and the other eye, I guess, I don't know if this was the blind eye, but it just needs to be checked by an ophthalmologist, and, you know, they said, it, you know, it should be all right. So, you know, just in prayer, praying for her, not she wasn't present, but somebody stood in proxy for her. You know, this girl sent me the text telling me, hey, you know, everything's good. They can't find anything. And there's been a host of stories like that. You know, a young lady had an embolism in her brain. This is back 2012. And my brother would call me. I mean, he would just dig up people that needed healing. And he called me about this lady. And she had an embolism and they had to do an operation on Friday. And she came on a prayer line. I had a prayer line back then. She came on at Thursday night. And we prayed for her. And the Lord said, you won't need the operation. She went in Friday morning, got to the hospital. They were getting ready, prepped her. They took an x-ray to see what's going on. They sent her home. There was nothing there anymore. It disappeared. Okay. Another gentleman around that same time, 2012, a Korean gentleman in Maryland, he had a stroke on a Monday. And my brother called me and said, hey, this guy works with me in the post office and he had a stroke and he has a right side paralysis. His brain is bleeding, you know, and he can't move the right side. I told him, okay, have his wife call me tomorrow, Tuesday at 12. When she called me at noon, you know, we prayed and I command, I come against the spirit of, you know, a cerebral vascular attack, which is the stroke, and I commanded to be gone, and the Lord spoke to me and told me by the end of the day, his right leg will be moving and the bleeding will stop, and in a couple of days, he'll be up and walking again. And that evening, 6 p.m., my brother called me and said, hey, we just leaving the hospital. The bleeding has stopped, and he's moving his right leg. I was like, okay. By Thursday, they said that he's up and out walking around, and they had a physical therapist come in, and the physical therapist came in like a week later to check him, took him outside. He walked and ran up and down the steps, and she told the doctor, let him go home. There is nothing wrong with this man. So the doctor showed the charts and said, but look, this man had a severe stroke. And she said, listen, I don't go by charts. I go by mobility, and there's nothing wrong with him. He doesn't even have paralysis. So let him go. So he went home. So, he went back to work about a month later, took some time off and went back to work. So, to God be the glory. This is how, amen. The Holy Spirit moves, God moves, and he's doing this for the people. So, amen. God bless y'all.
Wow. Hi, Brother PK. That's amazing. Again, how we met, I saw this firsthand. And that's when I said, I can't just be selfish and witness this and, hold on to it and not bring it to the people. So that's what we're going to do. We're going to do a Facebook Live October 24th, 7 p.m. Eastern. So get ready, folks. And one of the questions I had, do they have to be present? But you just answered that. You can have a proxy sit in for them, and you could do the deliverance through that proxy. So, folks, again, just tell everybody, tune in, Facebook Live, October 24th. Prophet PK will be offering deliverance. This is a treat. This is an absolute treat, because we know the level of pain and suffering and the affliction that is impacting our communities every day. And you have nothing to lose, right? What do you have to lose? The pain continuing. Okay, so tune in October 24th, 7 p.m. Eastern, and just join us and get delivered. But Prophet PK, appreciate you, my brother. I know you got to run and deliver some more. So again, man, love you, man, and we will talk to you real soon. October 24th, 7 p.m. Eastern, everybody.
All right. Amen. God bless you, sir. Thank you very much. God bless y'all.